So in my last video, I talked about adding more variation to the houses using something called
procedural generation.
And yeah, it came out kind of dumb. I said I'd work on it another time. Well, I guess the time is now. The first thing on the list of things to do is make a good color palette. Because like Isaac Newton once said after he invented colors, if your game has bad art, then you should probably learn colors. I guess. Bad jokes aside, I decided to go with Johnny's approach to using colors. I don't know why, but the idea of using a different swatch for each level of the game seems like a really unique and original concept to me that I can't wait to implement for the first time in any of my games. So after sleeping through the greater half of GDC's The Art of Journey
trailer that we actually
I got bored and wrote some code to randomly generate swatches for me. But later I used a really cool online palette generator called Cooler. I used the palettes I made to make these mockups right here. Tell me what you think about it in the comment section. When I was done with that, I finally got started on the main feature of today's video. So when I first did procedurally generated houses in my first video, I basically made a set of rules that I wanted the generation process to follow. Basically, it makes a box of tiles, then carves out some tiles and adds what I would like to call frontages. Then it updates the tiles, which makes for some cursed houses. But with some more rules, they actually started looking a bit better. But as you can imagine, the code being more complicated, the more complex the houses that I wanted to make would be, it really just wasn't a good way of doing things. If only there was a way I could randomly generate unique houses and also have the quality control and simplicity of hand-drawn houses. If only I could have the best of both worlds. I said. Did someone say color images? If you don't know what color images are, they are basically images, but with colors. Think of an image as a grid of pixels, and each pixel holds data containing a color's RGB values. So basically what I'm trying to do here is make a color image, then pass that bad boy into some code which follows some rules, and boom, a pretty decent house. And as you can see, I've put that into practice, and like always, works perfectly on the first try, excellent programming as usual.
You don't have to, you can never make it. Because you cannot do basic 1 plus 1!
After about 4 hours of frantic crying and rethinking my life choices as usual, I finally got to working. Finally, I can check it off my checklist. My OCD won't let me put it in the done list because it's not perfect yet. So right now the game is divided into three different biomes. The mid biome, which are basically the suburbs. The low biome, which is the equivalent to Terrible Terrabelle from that Boondocks episode. And the top biome, which is the equivalent to Beverly Hills from that Simpsons episode. Lastly, I made the background color change depending on what biome the player is in. If you've watched this far, then consider subscribing. If I'm honest, I'll just make you cry.